Hi, Apes. Today we're taking a look at Unit 8, Part 3, which is going to focus on wastewater treatment. Now, wastewater is pretty much anything that goes down a drain in your house. So, toilet water, shower water, sink water, dishwasher, anything that goes down a drain goes to a wastewater treatment plant. So, with wastewater, in some cities they have what's called a combined sewer system that both wastewater and stormwater might get funneled into a wastewater treatment plant. Now, when you have this combined sewer system like you have up here, here's all our household waste, and then you also have stormwater runoff that might get funneled to the wastewater treatment plant. Now, this can be a dangerous system to have because when you have too much water, you might overflow your sewer system with too much runoff water, and that means that that wastewater treatment plant is not going to be able to handle that waste runoff. And so there's going to be some safety mechanisms that allows untreated sewage to go into your surface waters. So this combined sewer system is a little bit of an older system. You might see these in older cities because it's hard to retrofit and build new sewage systems to get into your wastewater treatment plant. But most cities in the United States will not have a combined sewer system. We will have our stormwater drain that goes into our surface waters, and then we'll have our wastewater drains that go to our wastewater treatment plant. Now, if you live in a little bit more of a rural area, you might have a septic system. So, a septic system is like your own little mini wastewater treatment plant that everything that goes down a drain in your house gets funneled out to your septic tank. And in your septic tank, you'll have bacteria that you have to periodically flush down your toilet or put down a drain so that you can keep those bacteria happy in there. So they will work on breaking down your waste, and then it will go out into a drain field to be further treated by filtering down through soils and through bacteria that live in the soils before making its way into our groundwater system or surface waters. So typically, if you have a septic system, you also have a well, and you won't be connected to our county water and sewer lines. Now, most of us are connected to wastewater treatment plants, and for the most that you will have for steps are 4 steps with wastewater treatment. So the primary treatment is definitely required by law everywhere, that wastewater will get filtered through to a large tank where physical properties are allowed to just let waste settle. One of the first steps is it encounters a screen to get out any of the big stuff. Okay, so it'll filter out some of that big stuff before putting it into the tank. So a primary treatment is entirely physical. So this either uses a screen to catch things, or it uses gravity. So heavy stuff will sink to the bottom and light stuff will float to the top. So this is a physical step. Now, in some very remote areas that are near an ocean, they might be able to release some of their wastewater at that stage because you can dilute it in a large amount. But we really don't see that anymore because we're too populated in all these areas. So the next stage we'll go to is secondary. In secondary, we qualify this as biological because this uses microorganisms to break down your waste. So that's why we refer to this as biological. One of the big targets here in secondary pollutant is nitrogen removal because nitrogen is in all of our waste products. Now, in some areas, they'll go through tertiary treatment. Now, tertiary treatment is not everywhere. This is considered to be a kind of a polishing step, and it's to get rid of extra things that that area might be prone to. Sometimes it's chemical and sometimes it's physical. For us in our area, because we're in the Chesapeake Bay watershed, we have to worry about eutrophication. And so for us, for tertiary, it does remove phosphates. Because that is one of the big concerns with our Chesapeake Bay is that we have too much nutrients running off in there. And so anything we can do to prevent this point source from wastewater, we do. So we use tertiary to get rid of phosphates. In some areas, particularly if you have a combined sewer system, you might have a lot of clay particles, so you might need a physical filtering. So really it is very catered to your particular needs. And then everyone will do disinfection. So disinfection is to kill the bacteria that we find in our wastewater. Typically, we use chlorine. We put chlorine in and then we take it out because chlorine is toxic, but it is very effective at killing bacteria. Other options are to bubble in ozone gas that will be toxic to bacteria, or run it under a filter of UV lights that will help to kill bacteria as well. So that's a summary of the steps. So let's take a little bit of a closer look at each of them. So here's our primary treatment, remembering that primary treatment was physical. So with our physical treatment, one of the first steps that it encounters is a screen. So it's a big screen that just moves really, really slowly. It catches toilet paper, catches solid stuff that maybe didn't dissolve along the way. And anything that gets caught in this screen will go and get incinerated. So most of our wastewater treatment plants will have incineration capabilities on site, so they'll burn them right away. And then it goes to a settling tank. And so here, whatever's heavy will sink to the bottom, and whatever's light will float to the top. So things like oils will float to the top. Because remember, a lot of this is cooking waste as well that goes down your drains. So we have oils at the top and solids at the bottom, and you have a bar that comes across the top. And it skims everything off the top, and then it drops to the bottom, and it skims everything off the bottom. And it just keeps going like this in a rotation to allow us to scrape away these materials. And it'll often go to a second settling tank to do this again because you just have to let water settle, and all the heavy stuff will sink to the bottom, and all the light scum will float to the top. That's what they call it. They call the stuff on the bottom sludge. The heavy stuff and the stuff on the top, scum. So they'll scrape the scum off the top, drop down, and go to the sludge. And they'll dispose of all that. They'll burn the sludge. That is straight waste. So after it goes through our primary treatment, it moves to secondary treatment. So all of the solid stuff has been taken away, but we do still have a lot of suspended material in here. So very, very light stuff that wouldn't settle out. A lot of this are nitrogen-based compounds. So what happens is we put in a lot of bacteria and protists. So in here, we kind of feed this area with all sorts of microorganisms. Now, the point of these microorganisms is they're going to break down that biological nitrogen. They'll eat it up, they'll consume it. So we often have to aerate this tank because remember from eutrophication that decomposition and the consumption of this material uses a lot of oxygen. So we have to keep feeding these guys oxygen so they continue to break this down. Sometimes we'll refer to this stage as BNR or biological nitrogen removal because we are counting on those microorganisms to do a lot of this for us. So in this case, we're kind of simulating a wetland where once you have water that flows into a wetland, it slows down, things settle out, and then all the microorganisms will start to break down those nutrient wastes. After our critters have all eaten, they're all kind of fat and happy. So you put them in another settling tank so that the critters and any fine waste might be able to settle out. Now, these little critters, we actually recycle them. Okay, so they might go back in and try it again in a couple of weeks. But there is always excess that grows because they're reproducing and you have waste that settles out. So some of that waste might also be incinerated. At this stage, though, some of this sludge that comes out might be incinerated, some might be composted, or some might be used as fertilizer at this stage. So it can be sold as fertilizer. We wouldn't sell this waste up here. This is just too solid. But these, it has a lot of microorganisms and that nitrogen component to it, so it might be a good fertilizer. After it goes through that settling tank, let me actually back up. It might go to tertiary treatment. Okay, so this is just a little bit out of cycle because tertiary treatment is not done everywhere. So here, this shows a filter that might filter out fine particles. For us in our Chesapeake Bay watershed, we use a chemical treatment to get rid of our phosphates. So we put a chemical in that causes the phosphates to form a solid or to form a precipitate, and then it can be scraped out. So remember that tertiary phase is just kind of a polishing step that you're going to target the pollutant that you need to get rid of. In a lot of cases, it is phosphorus, and they'll form a phosphate salt. And then finally, before you release it, everyone will have to disinfect their water. The most common one is chlorine, that we put chlorine water in, or we put chlorine in the water. And then we do have to take the chlorine out because it is toxic. So that is that stage where we'll put it in and then we'll take it right back out. And so once that water has been disinfected, then it is okay to go to the stream. Okay, so that is the stage, and we will practice with this. You'll be able to sort some cards around to determine what are our primary treatment steps, what are our secondary, what are our tertiary, and then that final disinfection before we release it to the stream. So just make sure you ask any questions that you might have, and we will take a look at this next class.